Yo, what's up guys? Welcome back. So, for us TCG players, we had the release of ABC past weekend, and we already know that the ABC deck has been running rampant. A lot of players decided to pick ABC as their main choice for past weekend's tournaments, like regionals, for example. And ABC did well, very well, for the first weekend here for the TCG. But this is a very interesting note, or a very interesting thought, or yeah, something very interesting for the OCG. You know, Zodiac Beast were released from the new set. Back in the OCG, and I will leave a link in the video description to the Road of the King website. Very interesting website to keep up with, like, the OCG news next to the Yu-Gi-Oh! Organization website. So again, the links will be in the video description, so feel free to check out the links down below. And just a flashback from last week's episode of the OCG and the game breakdown. You know that until at least for the first weekend, when Zodiac Beasts and the new set Raging Tempest was released, ABC was still the best deck. ABC was still the best deck, or at least the deck to beat, sitting at about 27%, followed by Metal Foes. Metal Foes had an increase in play due to the fact that ABC, or at least most ABC players, decided to drop anti-spell Fragrance from their main deck due to the mirror matches, right? But yeah, Metal Foes sitting at second place, and Zodiac Beast during their first weekend already saw at least about 9% of the top deck list consistent of Zodiac Beasts and variants, followed by Cosmos and then the other deck list like Dark Lords, Totem Pals, DDTs and Heroes. But now, so for past weekend, again, major props for Road of the King for these results. And astonishing is that the new deck, Zodiac Beast, kinda completely dethroned ABCs from their first place. So it seems that past weekend that Zodiac Beast is, or this can be considered being the better deck over ABCs. But yeah, still, it's very early quote-unquote format. The decks, or at least Zodiac Beast, were just released. So still, give ABC players, or give the ABC deck, the time to adapt to the new cards. But still, according to the website, that the ABC decks were more present in the tournament compared to Zodiac Beast. And then it's something interesting, or at least it's interesting to see that, that it's a bit contradicting that more Zodiac Beasts decklists are topping compared to the amount of ABC decklists in the top, since as you see here, about 33% of Zodiac Beasts topped past weekend in the OCG, followed by ABC sitting at about 16% and Metal Foes Infernoids due to Lawn Mowing Next Door. You know, the gimmicky 60 card build, at least 60 card builds, Infernoids / Lightsworn decks sitting about 6-7%, and then the usual decks we know. And very interesting, Cosmos only sitting at about 4.4%, pretty much at full force. Well, yeah, Emergency Teleport is at 1 if I'm not mistaken, but you know, Triple Dark Destroyer is still a thing in the OCG. But things we can conclude from these results, yeah, I'll also show a few deck lists in the background from past weekend. But things to conclude is that the relevance of hand traps, you know, Maxi and mainly Ghost Ogre as well, are becoming more and more important due to the Zodiac Beast matchup. You know, you can compare Zodiac Beast with a deck like Windups. As soon as they go off, you know, with Windups and Mighty, the red, and into Hunter, the hand loop, if you don't have hand trap, you're like screwed. And that is the same with Zodiac Beast. If they're able to go like a normal summon their red and get the XC shenanigans going, it's very hard to come back from that. So something like a Maxi or a Ghost Ogre should save you in that situation. And as you also saw in the decklist, Book of Moon or Triple Book of Moon is becoming more popular because it's so versatile. And of course, it can be used during your opponent's turn as well, since it's of course a quick play, but during your own turn as well, to put that Drancia from your opponent face down, so it cannot use its effect during your own turn. But as said before, ABC's was one of the, at least was the most played deck past weekend in these tournaments, but still, Zodiac Beasts managed to get more tops compared to ABC's. And Metal Foes are again increasing due to the fact that ABC players are dropping anti-spell Fragrance from their main deck. So still, yeah, conclusion for these results for the OCG, still very early. The ABC deck slash the ABC players has to adapt, or they have to adapt to the new deck, the new archetype, Zodiac Beasts. So they have to change their deck compared, or at least they have to combat this new archetype and new deck. Possible explanation for this is that more people decided maybe to run the new decks. People are just fed up of playing with the standard ABC decks. So more people maybe prefer running Zodiac Beasts, but still, again, as I said before, more decks in these tournaments were ABC compared to Zodiac Beasts. But again, very interesting to see how this is going to develop for the OCG. And of course, later in a few months, the impact it's going to have for us DCG players. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching and feel free to leave a comment or a like if you enjoyed the video. Leave them standing out. Peace.